What's going on, guys? Sorry it took so long for another video to come out. Last week I was upgrading my UCAs and I subsequently took apart my LCAs to clean them, and then when I put them all back together the alignment was way off, and so I took it to this alignment shop and I called up a whole bunch of other alignment shops and they all told me that they couldn't do anything to my alignment, and I was driving along the road and I almost crashed. So here we are. I give up. Anyways, here's the next video. Oh, and I started a TikTok account. Go ahead and check that out. There's a link below. Okay, on to the main course. 10 great gift ideas for anyone who enjoys car camping, overlanding, 4x4, or even people that don't do that type of stuff. I mean, it's the holidays, right? So why don't we do a video like this? And the greatest thing about all these items that I'm about to mention is that almost every single one of them were gifts to me. So you know it's tried and true. The first thing that we are going to talk about is this little lantern light, whatever you want to call it. So this flashlight, it's packed with a ton of features. There's a mode for a flashlight in the front. Okay. Whoa.
Great for campfire horror stories.
So a really great torch for the front here. I don't know how many lumens, but it's a lot of lumens. And there's various modes too. You click it a couple of times, it gets dimmer. And then on the back, there's another button for this overall lantern lamp thing. And so that is a good light for sort of like an all around at night when you want to illuminate the table. Or it even comes with these, okay, I'm gonna turn this off because I can't show you. But it has these cool little hooks. I don't know if you can see it. Cool little hooks that kind of, they have two of them. Two hooks that just kind of come up so you can hook them on to a branch, to a rope, anything like that. Hang it up high and you'll have nice overhead lighting. And again, comes in various modes. So you can have the whole side. You can have only half the side of it. See that only half of it's illuminated. Oh, geez, okay. And then you can have some red light. Okay, so that's good for nighttime, and so it won't attract the mosquitoes and it's easier on the eyes. And then you have like a flashing beacon, if you will. This is a great little item. And there's also a port on the back here. There's one USB port that you can plug into to charge your electronics. So that's nice for an emergency. I wouldn't count on this to be your main source of electricity, just because it'd probably run out before your smartphone even charges. But that's a good, nice little feature to have just in case. And it also comes, look at this, with a USB cord just nicely attached to this thing. And when you don't wanna use it, you just kind of wind it back up and just click it into place. This is, I think it's about, what is it, about like $30 on Amazon. So for all these products, I'll be putting Amazon affiliate links below, so make sure to check those out. If you use those links, they support me, and this is all I do. I don't do any of this stuff for money, so that would be amazing if you guys check that out. It has a nice little handle here as well. I didn't show you that in the beginning, but overall, for 30 bucks, you can't go wrong with this. So the first thing is this nifty little flashlight lantern thing. So the second thing on the list is this spare tire bag. So I don't know if you've seen anything like it before, but it's basically a gigantic backpack for your spare tire. And it mounts with these straps that goes in a cross pattern on the spare tire. The capacity is huge. I don't know exactly what the capacity is for this, but these bags range from about, depending on if you get the branded ones like this Trash Root or some of the no-name ones, between say like $30 to $50. And you can see it's great because it has all these pouches that you could put other bags and other gear in as well. It has some MOLLE attachments in the front, so you could attach even more bags to it. And on the inside, it's just one giant compartment that you can put your garbage. So if you're driving along the trails and you don't have any room to put your stuff or something that's like kind of grimy or has a lot of dirt in it inside the vehicle, you could just toss it in here. I've collected firewood. I've put gas jugs in here because I couldn't put it up on the rack. Basically anything, recovery straps that are dirty, any shackles, recovery gear, This is a fantastic thing to have to expand the carrying capacity of your FJ when the inside's full. And my old one was stolen off the back of my truck, so this was actually a gift. It's a great one to have. Okay, so the next thing that we're gonna talk about, it's not actually all that common. I don't see a lot of people using it, but to me it's a no-brainer. After I received it as a gift, I've been using it ever since. And it's a fold-up pail, or bucket, if you will. It's made with this tough vinyl material, and this one is 16 liters. And you get these again off Amazon. And when it's loaded up and it's seated properly, this thing doesn't tip over, it stays as it should. So what I've used this for is I've used it to collect rainwater when it rains. You can use it to wash dishes. You can, using it to transport water from the lake. The list goes on, but anything that you can use a bucket for, this is perfect. And it collapses just as easily as that. So you can just tuck it away somewhere and doesn't take up any room at all. So, plastic bucket. Now, moving on to the next item, which actually works with this plastic bucket, is a portable shower head with a pump. Yes, you heard me right, showering. And you might be thinking it's a huge apparatus, it's so fancy, it's so complex, but no, it's actually just a hose with a shower on it, and the end of it connects to a pump. So you have your shower head, your telephone shower thing, if you will, and you would screw it in to this pump. Okay, so I'm not gonna screw it in right now, but you're gonna screw it in, have it nice and seated. You're gonna turn on this motor, and you're gonna stick it in a body of water. And where do you stick it when you have no body of water? You fill up your pail with some lukewarm or cold water if you're into that. Stick that pump in there, and you have a running shower. This is hilariously awesome, and I've used it before on the trails. It's so effective. And they also come with these neat attachments. So suction cups. So you basically put the suction cup up against the side of your car, and you just hang your shower head on that suction cup, and you just don't even need to carry this thing. Like, who thinks of this stuff? Whoever you are, it's awesome. But yeah, if showering was an issue that has stopped you from going camping before, well, you're in luck, because you could just grab one of these things and you're good to go. Oh, so I forgot to mention, so this thing is, it's rechargeable, right? Like everything should be, right? So it's rechargeable by USB. Yeah, it's rechargeable by USB. So you basically, you open up this compartment over here, stick the power in, and you just charge it up. So you just charge the battery for your showers. Amazing. All right. The next thing that we're gonna talk about is something that I actually do not have. Well, I mean, I have it. It's just, I don't need it. And what I mean by that is a surface, a table surface. So I have these tables, they're built into my storage unit. And if you haven't seen that build video yet, I'm gonna throw a link up here. Yeah, they're built in, they slide out, and I have a surface that I can use to work, to eat, to prepare things, whatever it is, you name it. I found that before I made this, one of the biggest things was whenever we got to camp, having a surface to work on, like a table, was very important. And there are these new tables that have come off the market that are just kind of like planks of wood or planks of whatever it may be, aluminum, but they fold up nicely, okay? So it's like a folding table, and then the legs attach, sort of like those camp chair attachments, and you have a nice small surface that you can work off of. And so I've been researching these a while, but I didn't really need one because I already had these things, and I've combined them with milk crates to make a table. But yes, so small camping table, it's a great gift. These things cost about like $50 off Amazon. So, I mean, it's a small, affordable gift that I'm sure every single car camper or overlander or 4x4 person would love. So the next thing that I have here is a tire deflator. So if you're like me and you go out on the trails, you do a lot of overlanding on roads that are anything but asphalt, you'd want to lower your tire pressures so that you'd get a better footprint, better grip, better ride when you're out on the rocks, on sand, whatever it is that you're driving on. You'd find that, yeah, it'd take a pretty long time for tires to deflate. You're basically standing there going like, whereas with this thing, it even has a gauge on it. You screw it onto the stem and then you detach the valve. And then once you put it in the open position, this thing goes, and within like 5 seconds, your tire's at the right pressure it needs to be. And so this is actually very useful if you're doing it in the summer and you live in an area that has a lot of mosquitoes and you're sitting there deflating your tires going tss, tss. Meanwhile, you're getting 1,000 mosquitoes trying to bite you all at once. This thing, it's gonna save you a little bit of an itch. It's gonna save you a lot of time. It's a nice little thing to have. Got this as a gift. And it's very handy, what can I say? The price of a deflator like this one is a branded one, it's ARB. Those go for a little bit more, about $70. But they do make sort of like aftermarket, no-name ones for cheaper, like $30. I haven't tested those out yet, so I wouldn't be able to tell you how those work. But the range is between $30 to $70. So it's a decent price point for a nice little gift. So now that we're done talking about those tire deflators, we're gonna go on to some comfort. So this is a camp chair, and it's not like one of those $5 camp chairs that you get at Walmart that basically open out like this and then fold away like this. These things are the more compact versions, and this is actually a taller sitting chair, so that's why it's a little bit bigger. But the ones that are a little smaller, the ones that a lot of people take hiking, they can pack away in a small size, sort of like this. Basically comes with the fabric portion, which is a chair, and then an assortment of legs that you kind of just put together, and then you put the fabric over top, and you have a nice thing to sit on. So the selling point of these chairs is that it's compact, it's strong, and it's small. So you can pack it away and bring it with you when space is a problem. These chairs used to be really, really expensive, and newer companies have sort of created their own versions of these chairs. They look exactly the same, and they cost like a fifth of the price. So there are chairs like this on Amazon, and again, I'll throw links below, that cost around $30 to $35, maybe even $40, but they're super durable, they're light, they pack up small, and they're comfortable. I think that's a great little gift to give someone. You can never have enough chairs, right? Like, you go camping with people, even if you have one, you can have another, and maybe you want to switch it up sometimes, yeah? You might want to switch it up sometimes. Sometimes you don't want to sit on your regular chair, you want to sit on your new nice chair. Another great thing that's affordable, and this is for the coffee drinkers out there, are different types of coffee makers. I know most people that drink coffee, when they go car camping, they usually just get the instant stuff, which is great. But if you're like me and you like fancy coffee and you get beans and you like to grind them yourself and you're a snob and you're like, oh, I need the good coffee, I can't drink the bad coffee, oh my god. Well, there's a solution for you. So these things are really common, these metal French presses, so you don't have to get the ones that are glass and then risk breaking things everywhere and then cutting your whole body up. Really simple. This one's a little bit of a pricier one, it's a titanium, but you can get ones that are much cheaper, made of aluminum, and just works. It's a French press, so it works like it should. So these things, yeah, they're about around 50 bucks. This one was about 60, 70. That's on the higher price point, so you find yourself a cheaper one on Amazon. I'm gonna put the link down below. And then if you wanna go one step further and you'd much rather have something that tastes like espresso, there are mechanical espresso makers, like coming in a little small package like this, maybe cost a bit much. But this thing only cost why didn't I look up the prices before this video? This thing costs about like 30 to 40 to 50 bucks. depending on where you get it. If you haven't used an AeroPress before, this is basically what it is. It's an AeroPress, and it uses the pressure to give you something that tastes like an espresso. You just brew it in this little compartment over here. Put a filter in this thing, close it up, and put it upside down, and you're just gonna press it all the way down. And then you have your espresso. So again, both these things, both under $100, you can get them relatively at the same price point, between like 30 to 50. Yeah, nice little gifts if they don't already have something like this. Sweet Jesus! So the next thing that I have on the list is something that my sister actually showed me, and she asked me if I wanted it. So I don't actually have it yet, but I played around with it and it was really cool, and is basically, so it's not this. So this is a Zippo lighter, and it's a Zippo lighter, but it's electric. And so it operates the same way. You open the thing, okay, and then you press a button, and these two crisscrossing bolts of electricity. So yeah, that's basically it. I thought it was pretty cool. I prefer using matches because I'm weird like that. I always run out. And so the more I thought about it, the more I thought it would be a decent thing to have around, because like, you don't run out of it. The only thing you could run out of with that electric one is battery juice. And well, what do you do when you run out of battery juice? You just plug it in. There's a USB plug-in to this lighter. No lie, when you turn this thing on, and like there's this like two lightning bolts like this, tell me you don't want to touch it. I went and touched it and it felt like some small rodent was biting my finger. Anyways, so it's not dangerous, it won't kill you. And that is about $20 on Amazon. I'm sure whoever you get it for will be really thrilled with it. They'll always have a use for something like this. I mean, who doesn't like lighting stuff on fire? And the last thing on the list is more electronic charging banks. Cause let's be real, everything these days runs on some sort of recharging capability, like the flashlight, like the electric lighter, the portable shower, but you also have your phones, you have your headphones, you have other people's phones and other people's headphones. And maybe if you have a camera, if you're like me, you have a drone, you have other cameras, camera slides. In 2020, things have gotten so much cheaper than they were before. Now you can get a 20,000 milliamp hour battery pack for like $40 on Amazon. And so yeah, the last gift idea that I have is more electronic charging banks, because you can never have enough. So that's it, guys. That's my 10 things as gift ideas for this holiday season. Perfect for people who love car camping, overlanding, 4x4, whether it be yourself, your friends, or, you know, if you found these things useful for people that don't do those things, I mean, go right ahead. They're so cheap. They're great stocking stuffers. Thanks for tuning in. For all those items, I'm gonna put my Amazon affiliate links below, so check them out. And if you do plan on buying them, please use those links, because they do help me out. They don't cost you an extra cent, but they do give me a little bit of it, and it would help me support this channel so much. So I thank you in advance. And as always, thank you for being a subscriber, and thank you for tuning in here. If you haven't already subscribed, you like this video, you like all my other videos, hit me a subscribe and a thumbs up. Honestly, that is the best thing that you could do for me right now. I'm gonna see if I could try to get to 1,000 subs before Christmas. Imagine that, eh? Wouldn't that be a great Christmas gift? To become a YouTube monetized creator by Christmas.
A guy can dream.
Yeah, I appreciate all the support here, and I'll see you in the next video.